Hi, Leo. Welcome to your November 2019 tarot card reading. Thank you so much for being here. Let's go ahead and jump right into this beautiful spread that we have laid out in front of us. The very first card that came out, which indicates your energy specifically, Leo, is the Knight of Wands, which we love, right? A Knight of Wands for a fire sign is kind of like one of those signs, like it's okay to go have fun, right? It's okay to lighten up. It's okay to, you know, take your responsibilities and fulfill them, but to also like really enjoy life. There's a quality of expansion here. This is very Sagittarian like, and this is especially relevant to you because we have Jupiter finishing out his transit in your natural fifth house in the sign of Sagittarius. So I think you're going to feel the effects of that Jupiter transit, like really taking on a lot of that creation energy, wanting to take yourself to new places. Maybe there's some travel in it for you. Maybe there's some like, I gotta go, I gotta do, I have to go big or go home. And you may be really feeling a little bit of like, I'm not going to say pressure because I don't think that it's something external, but it's like maybe a sense of urgency. Like, I really want to do this. I really want to make this happen. I really got to go. I really got to move, you know. And some of you might be feeling like you're wanting to create a family. You're wanting to get married. You're wanting to like have fun with dating. You're wanting to create that business. You know, it's all creation, right? That's what the fifth house is all about. And the Knight of Wands is like, there's never any fear with the Knight of Wands. He's so light and buoyant, and he has this sparkle to him with everything he does. He draws people in. He's magnetic. So the fact that the very first card indicating you is coming out like this sets a tone for the upcoming 4, 5, 6 weeks that if you want, Leo, like if you want, anything is possible during this time, okay? If you're not restricted, if you're not holding yourself back, if you're not being realistic at this time, then some of the unrealistic stuff actually might happen. The environment in which you're operating is symbolized by the Judgment card. So this is very unpredictable. Any moment this lightning bolt can strike, any moment this awakening, this light bulb turning on can happen, and all of a sudden you have like this whole new perspective on your entire life, on the reasons for things, all the reasons why. This is especially relevant to you, and also the very first card that came out, which was the Star. Both of these cards, especially relevant for Leo, because you have Uranus transiting your 10th house. Uranus, ruler of Aquarius, and both of these are very Aquarian cards. They suggest that heightened enlightenment, like kind of, I'm not going to say detached for you guys, because I know you're still Leo after all, and you guys really care about the things that you care about. But there is an aspect of a higher purpose. There is an aspect of alignment that is very clear. I think it's clear. I think it's obvious. You can feel it happening. Your work is doing certain things. Your love life is doing certain things. Your money is doing certain things. And like everything has this potential energy, and it's just kind of buzzing or vibrating with all of this potential, and it's just kind of waiting. And I sense that you can feel that it's waiting. And the Knight of Wands is like, okay, let's not make things wait anymore. Let's start getting these things going. Let's start pulling these triggers, and let's start making these decisions so we can actually have that relationship and have that money and have that, you know, prestige or whatever. Like, let's go for it. All right. Now, I'm getting a strong message of expansion coming through the past couple of days for a lot of the readings, and you are no exception. This essence of expansion happening a lot internally because of the sun illuminating our scorpionic side. But also, like, right, there's always that reflection. So if we're experiencing expansion on the inside, then we're also experiencing expansion on the outside. And that's one of the beautiful things with Uranus in the 10th, Jupiter in the 5th, and Scorpio season. Okay, so when all of those three things kind of work together, there's this limitlessness. Is that a word? This limitlessness. There are no limits. And now is not a time to be conservative in the things that you're wishing for. Now is not a time to be like, okay, yeah, I'll wish for, you know, a relationship, you know, but it doesn't have to be like perfect and he doesn't have to be everything, but you know, as long as he meets this criteria, I'm good. It's not a good time to be shooting low. You know, and that's not a very Leo thing to do anyway. Normally the Leo and the fire energies in general, they're like, shoot, like, let's just go for it. You know, the shooting low is kind of an earth sign kind of thing, you know, so let's not be a fire sign and shoot low, because that's just kind of hindering yourself. Shoot for the stars, literally. Shoot for things that now, from this particular perspective, may seem or feel impossible. Like, just do it, you know, because if you don't do it, then you'll always kind of wonder what would have happened if you did, you know? I have this, the next card that comes out is this Two of Coins. Now, the top two rows, which you'll see when I put the camera down in just a second, the third row is exempt from this, but the top two rows, I'm getting this sort of wavering. So this Two of Coins is wavering between the Star and Strength. And it tells me that while simultaneously something is opening up for you, you are feeling that essence of expansion, you're also feeling a weight of something else. Strength is a beautiful card to get, but it means you have to be strong, or there is a circumstance in your life that is requiring strength. Sometimes that is physical strength, sometimes that is, you know, spiritual strength and longevity, sometimes it's perseverance and patience, and sometimes it's courageousness. So I'm not sure exactly how it's manifesting for you, but there does seem to be, you know, you seem to be in the midst of an occasion where strength is a necessity. And this sort of toggling of the Two of Coins, kind of going back and forth, well, do I need to stay and persevere and be courageous and be strong, or do I just kind of let go and kind of let go and let live and just let whatever happens, happens, you know? And you may feel torn, and these are two major arcana, so it's kind of like, I feel like there's only one that's going to be able to win. I don't know that these are necessarily energies that are working together right now, unless you start applying the essence of the Strength card to the Star energy, to your expansion, to your growth and prosperity. If you are trying to be strong for something that has presented a weakness or presented a heartbreak or something like that, then you're sort of tearing yourself, all right? There is a weight of something. There is an oppressive something. I'm going to kind of skip around on these cards. Sorry, it's not what I normally do, but just let's just kind of go with the flow of the narrative here. The reason why I'm saying all of this is because directly underneath the Strength card, we have the Three of Swords. So if you are dedicating your strength resource to a Three of Swords situation or circumstance, this can be a breakup, it can be disappointment within your relationships, it can be financial loss, right? It can be anything like that. If you're applying your strength to that, then it means you're not able to apply your strength to the Star. I feel like your awareness can only be dedicated to one to another, unless you take this strength and push it toward the Star. That's the only way it's really going to work. And if you want it to work, then that means that you don't necessarily need to give credence to this Three of Swords at all. And while this Three of Swords was experienced or is being experienced now, or whether it's something from the past, either way, I'm not going to tell you it doesn't matter, but it kind of doesn't matter. It kind of is like immediately, it's like so rapidly becoming your past that any dedication to it is just you continuing to live in the past. And maybe that strength too is like getting out of the past and moving toward the future. I don't know. I don't know how it's going to manifest for you exactly, but I do sense a pulling in two directions, okay? I sense that on one side, you really want to be in this Three of Swords place. And then on the other side, which you'll see here now, you really want to be at the Star energy, or in this case of the second row, you really want to be on the side of the Ace of Cups, which is directly underneath the Star. Sorry, I should put the camera down now so you can see, because I think the positioning of these cards is especially relevant for your reading somehow. Okay, so in the middle row, we have, you know, someone in the middle who's also the same directly underneath the Two of Coins, right? We have someone in the middle looking one way and running the other. How is that possible? And then you have Strength in the Star on the other side of this. You know, this tears us up inside when we feel this divided. This affects us greatly, and we lose energy when we're here. We feel drained. We feel exhausted. And it is fourth house, you know, Scorpio for you guys. Okay, I get it. Fourth house can be, like, really intense, coupled with the Scorpio energy. So it's like water upon water. Feelings upon feelings, you know. So, okay, if you are feeling like you're drowning a little bit, it is temporary. But we don't need to feel torn either. You know, we don't need to feel torn. Fourth house is also a place of safety too. You know, fourth house is a place where we feel like we can be our truest and our most authentic self, and we can have emotion and we can express emotion and be authentic in that way. So it doesn't have to be so draining, you know. Third house Mars might be kind of making your mind a little kind of like vibrating, kind of going all over the place, and a little bit difficult to control. That's fine, you know. But this is also an aspect of you, Mars in Libra, Mars in the third house, trying to establish balance between something. And I suspect it's a balance between your past and your future, and really deciding, is what's past really past? And is what is my future really my future? And, you know, kind of a blurred line there. The Seven of Swords, I always say, is like a betrayal or a self-sabotage. In this particular instance, I feel like it is more leaning toward a self-sabotage. Some of you may have had a betrayal in your life. There may have been someone that cheated on you or stole money or something. So if you continue to stay in that situation, then you are simply continuing to indulge in the Three of Swords, and then you are denying yourself the blessing of the Ace of Cups. You can't have it both ways. You can't have the Three of Swords and the Ace of Cups too. You have to create the space for the Ace of Cups, which is why the expansion is so important, which is why the Knight of Wands came out first to say, keep it light. You know, keep it light, keep it fiery, keep it low density. You don't need to be all like heavy and thick, you know, and palpable and all of this. Like, keep it like the wildfire of Sagittarius, all right? I always say that, you know, Aries is my spark, Leo is my bonfire, and Sagittarius is my wildfire. Well, this is the wildfire card. So this is about spreading things out. It's about being a little bit thinner and, you know, continuing to carve out your place, right? The way a wildfire carves out its place on the side of a mountain, you can carve out your place on the side of your mountain or your landscape of your future, okay? You don't need to be restricted to just one place. Uranus in the 10th isn't going to let you stay in one place anyway. I'm sorry, but you guys are going to be all over the place. A lot of decisions to make with your career and how you want to live your life and how you want to be seen and how you want to be appreciated. I mean, that's a no-joke kind of transit, right? It's a no-joke kind of transit. So it's not going to allow you really to stay in your past anyway. If you are dealing with a Leo who's like really stuck here, this is, first of all, it's probably not going to last that long before they start to like realize the effects of their self-sabotage, you know. Eventually they will have to make certain concessions, because this just simply cannot be permanent. The only thing that can be permanent is growth and expansion of consciousness, right? So choosing to stay here isn't really an option. I mean, you can choose to stay here longer, but eventually you're going to be forced to move on by having a tower moment or something, right? So this will break eventually, but you can cling on if you want, right? But then you're only denying yourself the Ace of Cups, and why would you ever want to do that? You know, this first column, which is so beautiful, like I said, the Star was on top of the Ace of Cups like this, and there's so much water kind of pouring down, and it pours down here to the Nine of Cups. So there's all this kind of watery energy coming through, and it's all very fluid, and there's a lot of motion, again, with the Knight of Wands, that kind of motion. This is a card of wishes coming true. It's a card of happiness. It's a card of pride and honor and dignity and living a life that you truly are, like, really, really proud of. And you're not trying to hide anything here. And you're also not trying to justify or defend anything, you know, just like, this is my life. I don't have to justify it. I don't have to tell you why I'm doing things, because I know that my blessings are coming. This is almost kind of like a baptism, I feel like, with all of this water being poured down on you. Like, there's a purification process going on big time, which, again, Uranus in the 10th. Uranus is all about purity. It's all about perfection. It's all about, you know, truly like the best of the best. And I think that's what's happening, is you are sort of washing away any feelings of guilt or shame or anything like that. Like, that kind of stuff is washing through your system so that it can no longer hold you back. The star doesn't ever want us to feel guilt and shame. It never wants us to feel stuck. It always wants us, like the cosmos, to continue spreading and being open and growing. Nine of Cups is a suggestion of, I feel ready to expand. I feel ready. Like, look how ready I am. Look how emotionally stable I am. Look how much hard work I've done to get those trophies up on the trophy case. That's what I always say, my emotional trophy case. Those of you who've been watching me know that I say that like all the time. The cups are like the representatives of the blood, sweat, and tears of your life experience, right? So here they are, up on the showcase, up in the trophy case, and I know you're very proud of it, and you should be very proud of it. And this is how you indicate to the universe that you are truly ready. You are going to have a moment here where the universe is going to say, like, okay, boom, here's the path, here's the direction, here's the information that you need. And sometimes that information could come through about this. Maybe some of you have yet to understand what these two cards mean. You know, that could definitely happen as, you know, we work toward our Pluto and Saturn conjunction in Capricorn in your guys' sixth house. That could definitely be still on the docket for you. Not to be afraid. This ultimately sets you free, because this ultimately kind of sets like something like a ricochet, almost, as though you come up and you hit a pretty intense boundary, a pretty intense barrier. Clearly, this roadblock was placed there for you, trying to get you to detour by the universe, specifically because you are not supposed to go down that path. This is like those big orange traffic cones with the construction guy with the big stop sign with like all the trucks and everything behind. Like, clearly, that path is not safe to go down. Okay, so if you don't know what this is yet, don't freak out when it appears, it's to your benefit, not to your detriment. A lot of times people feel like, yeah, but I really want to go down there. But they're like, yeah, but if you go down there, you're going to get hurt. You're like, yeah, but no, but I really, really want to go down. Yeah, but you're really, really going to get hurt. You know what I mean? It's just a matter of like really trusting the roadblock when you hit it and allowing yourself to take the detour toward the Ace of Cups, toward the Star, toward the Nine of Cups. All right. I have this feeling, okay, that there is an individual around you that is offering you some weird form of stability, okay? And they're kind of like a lot like you, right? This is the other energy that I'm getting. You're kind of back to back here. They're a lot like you, but there's an aspect of them that's safe to come home to. And I feel like there's a lot of these people appearing in these monthly readings, is that these are our best friends. These are our brothers and sisters, our parents, the people that really love us the most, that are really like our support network. They want you to go and be free and do the Knight of Wands thing. And they will absolutely be there to support you as you watch your world turning over. The very last card in the block we got was the World card. I think there's a wisdom quality I'm getting from the Knight of Coins. He seems to be wise beyond his years. So there might be someone who's like really into all the spiritual stuff that you like to talk to all the time. And they're going to offer you probably some like consistent messaging that you just kind of need to hear over and over and over. It is to your benefit. They probably will be offering you some truths about this kind of stuff. And, you know, if you find yourself a little bit in a questioning or a doubt or kind of like really can't decide kind of place, this is going to be the person that's going to egg you on toward the option that is of your best benefit. They're going to egg you on toward the Ace of Cups, toward the star energy. They back you up. They love you. They support you. And while they can be maybe a little bit critical at times, it is a Mercury retrograde after all. And these are kind of, representative of the Virgo archetype and the Sagittarius archetypes, both being mutable qualities, and they square each other, okay? And the squaring aspect of Virgo and Sagittarius, right, the sixth and ninth houses, well, I mean, really, for you, I guess that's not really the case. It's the second and fifth houses for you. Either way, it's a 90-degree angle. And that can kind of rub each other the wrong way sometimes, and you can kind of trigger each other. So this person might be annoyingly critical. They might be annoyingly realistic, but I'm telling you that what they have to offer is good, okay? It's not a hindrance to you in any way. This is probably not the person that is the Three of Swords, okay? This is like an observer of the Three of Swords, which means they have a clearer perspective, which, you know, like whenever we have like two friends going through a problem, like we can always step in and be like, yeah, but you should just do this, 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 and this. Like it's no brainer, obviously. But when you're in the midst of your Three of Swords, everything becomes so fuzzy and so hazy. This is not someone who's hazy. They're egging you on toward the Ace of Cups and the Star, but especially the World. They really, really do want to see you get to that point of flourishing, because they know what a Knight of Wands is capable of. They know what a Leo is capable of. They know what you are capable of, okay? So they see you in a way that you wish everyone would see you. And they expect you to kind of live into that potential, because potential is like all very well and good, but if you're not going to do anything with it, then who cares? They want you to be there. They want you to be at the top. They want you to be in that royal Apollo throne, you know, chariot, riding the chariot of fire across the sky. Like, they see that and they support that and they want that from you. This is not someone who is jealous. It's not someone who is like trying to get you to do anything or be anything. You know, they're just very supportive. Those very supportive people coming out real strong during Scorpio season, you're not alone in that. There's a lot of these cross messages coming through, and you know, it's a good thing, because a lot of times problematic people come out in these readings. So to have all these wonderful people coming out, it's kind of like a shift in perspective of like, okay, maybe all these problematic people just really aren't a part of my story anymore. Maybe they're just really not a part of my path anymore, because they seem to be fizzling out and disappearing this month, which is kind of like really a good thing, you know? Okay, I'm going to put the camera down now so you can kind of see now how they're laid out for real, and we'll continue the story. All right, thanks. Okay, Leo, let's start off with the Knight of Wands. I'm going to clarify his energy by pulling an astrology card and a moon card. Any additional information about you that you need? You know what's so weird about this reading? And when I first pulled out the cards and was just kind of sitting with them, was how the future is going in the opposite direction. Normally to me, to the right, because we write America, we read left to right, so it's like to the right is the future, to the left is the past. But when I look at these cards, I'm like, no, this is going the other way. Right? This is going, the future is like almost, you're like almost rewriting your past as you walk into your future. Does that make sense? I don't know if that makes sense or not. It's kind of a weird feeling that I got. Aries. Aries energy coming out big time. I think that's mirroring the Mars rulership of Scorpio season. Aries is powerful. It is potent. It is another fire energy, of course. It has directionality. It has this I gotta go, I gotta do it, I gotta make it happen, you can't stop me, I don't care what anybody says, kind of quality, which is why I think, you know, this is your soul, really, it's really servicing and saying, Leo, follow your heart, like, really, this is the whole Leo thing, right? Follow your heart. It wants you to follow, it wants you to move forward in that direction that makes you feel good. Fire signs chase happiness, right? Of all the signs, like fire and air, because of your like higher density or like lower density, really. Earth and water can usually cling to unhappiness pretty well, but fire and air have a hard time with that. They're like, no, man, like I just want to be happy. I want to be at those higher vibrations. And they do. So this is not a very fiery kind of place to be. There's like swords and rain and, you know, it's completely opposite of where you want to be. And this is kind of the Aquarian archetype, but it's you, right? Because all of those stars are actually suns. And you're like, I want to go be in the pantheon up there. Like, I want to go join those constellations. I want to be in my rightful place. Hold your vision. Yeah, fixed moon energy. Well, yeah, we had a new moon in Scorpio and a full moon in Taurus coming up here pretty quick in the next few days. So, you know, we've got like this whole aspect of, you know where you're going, you know where you should go, you probably know where you want to go. So why aren't you going there? Or like, what's the temptation to not go there? Because as far as I can see, there shouldn't be any reason why you shouldn't go where you want to go. Okay. Five of Swords, Seven of Swords, the same kind of deal. These are the cards that we're going to cover in the comprehensive, by the way. I just pulled them out so you can see them. These are cards that will talk for another like 20 to 25 minutes usually. We'll go into more detail. Sometimes the story takes some interesting twists and turns in the second half as we clarify. But let's go ahead and pull cards for the star. Interesting that Lover's reversed. Ooh, Three of Wands. It's all about the vision. Ooh, another Nine of Cups. Beautiful. We love that. Ooh, see? The answer is at the star. The answer is at the Ace of Cups. Be careful that you're not trying to rationalize anything. Now is not a time to be rational. You know what I mean? It's not a time to be reading between the lines of other people's behaviors and other people's narratives. It's not a time for you to try to like see the best in a bad situation. You know, it's just like, does it make you feel good or not? It's pretty black and white here. Does it make you feel good or not? Is it draining you? Or is it energizing you? Your body is like the most amazing indication system, right? Your body, your emotions, your gut feelings especially. There's so much information that can be found simply by feeling your way through it. It's not a function of the mind so much, even though that... Whoa, hold on, I'm not gonna take those. The third house Mars is probably trying to get you to be all intellectual about it. But that fourth house Sun in Scorpio, I'm sorry, Venus in the fifth house and Sagittarius, like there's no way. You gotta use your feelings on this one. Gotta use your feelings. Three of Swords is the Eight of Cups, by the way. Three of Swords is the Eight Cups. World reversed. Yeah, I mean, this is the difference, right? Are you going to self-sabotage and not go through your portal and not really kind of start painting that blank canvas? Or are you going to try to fix an oil painting that's already dry? You know what I mean? Dry and crusty and you're going to try to make it look better? I don't know. I don't think that's going to be possible for you. Let's look at this Three of Swords here. Look, Leo, when you know, you know. Deck upside down or what? No, I did not. Just a lot of reversals coming out. Well, let's look at this Knight of Coins. I like this Knight of Coins. I'm getting a real good vibe from them. Yeah, they seem to be your kind of like your touchstone, this place to come home to, this place to find safety, good advice, talk you down off the ledge a little bit. You know, off this ledge, not this one. They want you to jump off that ledge. Okay. These just fell on the floor here. Excellence. We love a Ten of Coins. And then Judgment. You're dealing with an Empress reverse here. That's a struggle a little bit. Empress reverse can be tough. Yeah, I think you're this. This is you. You probably, just FYI, not only in my readings, but probably in a lot of readings, it will probably be common for you to show up as Aquarian kind of energies because of this Uranus in the 10th, all right? So 10th house is very much about, you know, how we are in the world and all of that. So Uranus, Aquarius, it's just kind of what's happening in your transits right now. So I'm kind of leaning toward you taking on this very King of Swords energy with the Knight of Wands, which is lovely, even this kind of King of Cups, which is really nice. But yeah, okay. You're kind of getting a dose of the mind and the heart on overhaul here. All right. Let's go ahead and cut it off here. If you want to join me for the comprehensive, again, the link will be down in the description box down below. I wish you absolutely nothing but the best this Scorpio season. Have an excellent month, and I will see you next month. Take care.